Hey guys, it's Chris at Highline Guitars, and you're watching another episode of From the Luthier's Workbench. If you like to build or repair guitars, I suggest you click that subscribe button down below, and you'll become part of a community of fellow luthiers. And together, we can take your skills to a whole new level. If you'd like to support my guitar building YouTube channel, visit eGuitarPlans.com and buy a plan. A link is in the description below. Now on with the video. In this episode, I'm going to be covering part 21 of the Highline Echo Laminated Top guitar build. And as you can see, the guitar is almost completely assembled. All I have really left to do is to put the strings on it. But before I can do that, I need to do some work on the frets. So let's jump in and get started. Now, before I can jump in and start leveling the frets, there was a couple of other issues I needed to take care of first. One was I needed to repair some damage to the finish on the back. And then I needed to reinstall the pickups with the new pickup rings that I made for it and then solder them to the electronics. Once that was done, I could close up the control cavity and then jump into finishing leveling the frets. To repair the finish on the back, I brushed on several coats of Crystallac Bright Tone instrument finish, and then, once they had dried, I level sanded them smooth and took it to the buffer. The end result is a perfect repair without any witness lines. Next, I reinstalled the humbucker pickups with the new pickup rings that I had made after damaging the first set a couple of episodes ago. And if you remember, the original set had the grain running in a different orientation, which made the pickup rings weaker. So these new ones will be much, much stronger. And of course, once the humbuckers were reinstalled, I had to solder them to the three-way switch inside the control cavity. And then I finally was able to install the control cavity cover. And now I was ready to move on to the leveling process. And that begins by using a notch straight edge to make sure that the fretboard is absolutely dead flat level. And to do that, I'll adjust the truss rod if necessary to accomplish this. Before I level, I like to mark the tops of the frets with a red Sharpie. That helps me to gauge my progress as I'm doing the leveling process. Then I grabbed a 30-inch long, 12-inch radius sanding block with some 240 grit sandpaper to level the frets, and it only takes a few seconds. And just to make sure that everything is nice and level, I checked each fret with a fret rocker and then, if necessary, did some spot leveling. Next, it was on to recrowning each of the frets. When I recrown a fret, I like to use a three-corner file. I feel it gives me much more control, and I like the results. And here's a view of how I angle the file as I am working the crown on one of the frets. And I'll do one side, then move over to the other side, keeping the file at a roughly 45 degree angle to the fret. After recrowning the frets, it was time to dress the ends of the frets. And to do that, I'm using a very small dressing file from Stumac. And in fact, I'll put a link in the description down below in case you're interested in purchasing some of the same tools that I use for my fret leveling, crowning, and dressing work. But what I'm doing with this file is I'm basically just putting a facet around the beveled edge where it meets the rest of the fret, and that will help soften up any sharp edges. And then later on, as I'm sanding and polishing the frets, that bevel will become softened and will have much more of a rounded appearance. Now, I'm trying to show this technique using several different camera angles. It's kind of hard to explain exactly how I do this, so hopefully the camera angles will fill in the blanks, so to speak. But I will say I've done hundreds and hundreds of guitars, so experience does play a role in mastering this technique. But you could always practice on an old beater guitar to kind of get a feel for how you take down those edges on the frets. All the filing I've done has left marks in the frets, which I need to get rid of. And so the first thing I'll do is I'll mask off the fretboard to protect it. And what I'm using here is, this is binding tape that Stumac used to sell. I'm not sure if they still sell the same type, but I really like this stuff because it's very thick, sturdy, durable tape, and it does a great job of protecting the fretboard. At any rate, once I have the fret masked off, I'll sand the surface using some P500 grit wet dry sandpaper. And I'm just going to sand dry. I'm not going to introduce any water and do any wet sanding here. I'm just going to sand it to remove some of the more obvious marks left by my filing process. And then once I've finished sanding out some of the more obvious file marks, I'll grab some single-aught green synthetic steel wool, and I'll just rub the surface to start reducing the 500 grit sanding scratches. Then I'll switch to a maroon double-aught synthetic pad, and then I'll continue with a triple-aught gray synthetic pad. And I'll finish with a white 4-aught synthetic pad. And the end result is a pretty shiny surface. And this is what the frets look like after they've been polished with the synthetic steel wool. Of course, I can take it to a much higher level of shine by using a buffing wheel. However, I don't want to do that just yet. Instead, I want to make the nut and then string up the guitar, set the action, tune and intonate the strings, and then I'll play each string at each fret just to make sure that there are no other potential buzzing issues that would need to be addressed with some spot leveling. And then once I'm satisfied that the frets are as good as they can possibly be, then I'll grab that buffing wheel and make the frets shine like a mirror. All right, guys. Well, that's all the time I have for this episode. So I think what I'll do in the next episode is I'm going to make the nut, and then I'll string up this guitar and perform the final setup. So hopefully that's what will occur. Yeah. In the meantime, as always, click the subscribe button, hit the bell for notifications. Visit eGuitarPlans.com if you would like to help support my channel and get something in return. And until the next episode, take care, stay safe, and I will see you soon.